It's a framework for actually making sense of a patient's case and understanding where all the different treatment modalities will fit into that. So it'd be a greater capacity to guide the patient into making informed choices. And by informed choices, what we mean is choosing treatments that are going to offer the patient a measurable outcome, rather than taking on multiple modalities that may not get the patient anywhere, so it'd be a waste of time and money. Because in today's integrative medicine setting, where you're getting patients coming who are under various different practitioners, it's important to be able to collate all the information and to make sense of that information against the context of the patient's case. Otherwise, the patients can waste time and money on treatments that aren't going to get them anywhere. The value to a practitioner for being able to embrace this model is that they're going to develop a really good collaborative relationship with their patient. They're going to be working as a partnership where they can then monitor the treatment choices that a patient has made, and they can ascertain through that monitoring that the patient is actually moving forward and progressing in the right direction on their chosen treatments. The experience of the practitioner is that it clarifies the actual journey that the patient is on. One of the biggest problems is that patients will come to practitioners and saying, oh, I've read this and I've read that and I'm taking this and I'm taking that. Can you tell me if I'm doing the right thing? The practitioner at that point has to then go through all the products and treatments and try and make sense of those for the patients, which they haven't got time to do. And it can become very frustrating when patients find the latest bit of propaganda that hopes, you know, that offers a complete cure, and then the practitioner is presented with that bit of information, and can they factor that into the whole case? So a lot of case management just falls over just on that alone. Patients are unbelievably grateful because it's a way of filtering through all the propaganda. It's a way of filtering treatments that are really core to the patient's case. So it means they can spend their time, energy and money on treatments that they will know will take them somewhere, as opposed to treatments that offer nothing. So the whole experience of working with patients who undertake this model is immensely gratifying. What you form is a relationship where both parties are taking responsibility, they're both making informed choices, but more importantly, the patient is actively involved in that process, rather than you tell me what to do and you take all the risks. You see absolutely better results because you're actually choosing treatments that are core to the case rather than ones that are adjunct to the case. And you're monitoring, which means measuring the value of that treatment, and so if the treatment doesn't do what it's supposed to do within a period of time, you can change course. It would make an enormous change because you would enter into the role of, in addition to being a practitioner of your speciality, module is treatment agnostic, you would be in a position of being a patient advocate, which means that where you know that you can't help the patient, you would be recommending other areas that they may look at in order to help certain aspects of their case. This means you get a team of practitioners who collaborate and who all have the patient's endpoint as their compass. So they make sure that their treatments are going to take that patient on a particular leg of their journey in order to get to their endpoint. Yes, definitely. The trends, particularly with chronic disease, people are starting to understand that once you go down the route of using pills, whether they're alternative or pharmaceutical, you can, to address the symptoms, you then become product dependent. Most people don't want to become product dependent, they want to reverse their condition. So the trend is with people is, how can I improve my outcome? I want to be better, I want to have better health, I want to reduce my product dependency. So they're asking practitioners whether they can take them to that endpoint. The disadvantage of becoming product dependent is that products usually address the symptoms or the consequences of what's wrong. So what's wrong stays what's wrong, and it will deteriorate your health. So in other words, you'll end up a couple of years or less down the line having to take another product for the consequences of deeper symptoms because you failed to address or reverse the cause of the problem. For most patients who come for treatment, who are seeking ways to better their health, one of the key goals is to reduce their product and their drug dependency, yes. The fundamental approach that I myself would advocate would be addressing the causes, and the causes are lifestyle related for most of our chronic diseases. So there will be different things for different cases. It could be diet, it could be stress, workplace related toxins. So those are the things that you have to look at first. I had one of the most incredible cases, and it was a hopeless case. I thought it was a hopeless case. This lady was so chronically sick. She'd been dependent on drugs to manage her condition for about 16 years. She was taking heavy duty medications, corticosteroids, methotrexate. Her health was spiraling down. She was on sickness benefit. She had 2 children under 5, no husband. She couldn't afford a huge number of products, but she had to help herself. So she changed the diet. She went on a modified Gerson therapy. It took her 2 years to come off all drugs. She is now completely cured. It's absolutely fantastic. How does that make me feel? I feel so proud of that patient, and the enormous strength that she had to go against the medical profession in terms of the fear. You know, if you don't do this, then you're going to deteriorate even faster. In her case, she felt like she'd got nothing to lose because her life was hardly worth living in any case from the point of view of the long-term consequences. So I think patients who really do have those chronic conditions where they're drug dependent are probably the bravest, the most courageous, and they're prepared to do what it takes for the length of time that it takes in order to heal the body. And I think looking at it from a 16-year period of taking drugs to a 2-year period of recovery, that's not bad.